Something tells me you want to get back in the game, the MMA game.
Yeah, yes, sir.
So let me guess here. Is it Brock coming back after 4.5 years and, you know, you're about almost at the 3-year mark? Did that inspire you? Or is it your homeboy from Cleveland State winning a world title? I'm talking about Stipe Miocic. What is it? What is it that's kind of drawing you back in?
Everything you said, man. I'll tell you, man, here's a real reason why I retired. I've never told anybody this. I've kind of beat around the bush. I broke my hand a couple of times, but that wasn't it. I personally just wasn't happy. I had a lot going on. I was going through a divorce. I was closing my gym. I had a lot going on at the time. And when I retired, I just didn't want to fight anymore. People don't understand fighting is more mental than physical. Because, I mean, you know, look at Dan Henderson, man. He's not the greatest athlete in the world. The dude just loves to fight. And he just knocked out. Hector Lombard is 10 times as athletic as Dan Henderson. But in Dan Henderson's head, he feels like he's unbeatable, you know? So for me, watching Stipe win the title, that's one of the best training partners I ever had. He actually helped me start in MMA. I flew to Cleveland to train with him when I started fighting, and he was boxing. You know, a lot of people don't know Daniel Cormier started at my little bitty gym in North Tulsa. You know, I cornered him for his first fight. He cornered me for UFC 116. You know, I'm connected to all these. Watching Rashad. Rashad's a good friend of mine. You know, I basically, my personal life is so much better now. I have a beautiful wife. We have a child on the way. I have a gym. It's going great. I'm teaching high school. Like, I love my life right now. To me, fighting is not do or die. When I was fighting in 2010, I had only been fighting for 4 years. In every fight, I was just paying bills, and I was afraid to lose. You know, that's why my fights weren't so exciting. I was just afraid to lose, man. A lot of guys can relate to that.
Is there a particular fight you want?
I want some. Nah, man, I ain't calling nobody. Whoever the hell want to fight, like, seriously, I'm looking, dude, I took it back to 2009. When I got in the UFC, all I did was every day I checked you guys' website, your website, and I would see who pulled out of a fight, and I'd take the fight. That's how I got in, you know. And I'm doing the same thing now. I check the website every morning, every night, and I'm saying if somebody pulls out, I'll take the fight, you know. So I'm excited about it. You never know. It could be 2 weeks. It could be – and now this may sound crazy. If you ask another fighter – short notice fights are actually less stressful than having a 2-month camp. I don't have to think about this guy for 8 weeks. You know what I mean? So
well,
I'll take the fight on short notice.